Buddy, who's the best fighter in the world right now?
Louis Rose.
I'm just bushing.
You look at his face, it's like...
Who's that? He told me it's Javante Davis.
Javante Tate Davis.
I still say Terrence, bro.
Terrence Crawford?
Terrence is good, don't get me wrong, but Javante Davis is, he's an animal, man. He's, I don't know, I got with the vision, he's an animal. I don't see nobody beat him at 30, 35, 40. Don't be looking like?
I still say Terrence Crawford.
How would Crawford do against Pacquiao?
He'll stop Pacquiao.
I think it's too big, man.
Errol Spence fight?
Oh.
Terrence Crawford, Errol Spence?
I still like Terrence.
He's very talented, switch hitter.
He's versatile.
But Spence, both he and Spence never lost. So you can't really go and say there's a game plan how to beat them.
Well, it's not even about that. That goes to what we said earlier. Because the guy's undefeated doesn't really...
No, that's true. But I'm saying, like, sometimes when someone has a few losses, you kind of look what caused that or what can you exploit.
Right.
But Spence is big, strong. I went to see him this week. He's doing great. He hasn't missed a beat.
Oh, no. I'm not taking nothing away from Spence, man. You know what I'm saying?
No, Crawford's amazing, too.
Yeah, I'm not taking nothing away from Spence at all. Yeah, I mean, I think that he's right behind Terrence Crawford as far as being the best of 47.
You know what's crazy? In the 47 rankings, they have Spence, then Crawford, but on the pound for pound list, they have Crawford and Spence. How does that work? How are you number one in your division, but pound for pound, the other guy's ahead of you?
Hey, it's all about matter of opinions, man.
That's true. Were you ever on the pound for pound list, buddy?
Yeah.
And how do you feel about it?
I mean, I think it's a great thing. I mean, me and Pernell fought. Besides from my title, it was pound for pound. It was the best. So to be in that category, I don't care where I'm at. You know what I'm saying? Just to be in that category, to me, was an honor. So.
See ya.
And then they had a magazine cover, Boxing Magazine 92. They had Terry Norris, Riddick Bowe, me, and James Toney. Boxing's best, it said.
That's true. Do you still have it framed?
I have it. It's not framed, but I have it.
You should frame it.
I mean, then that's when, right after Riddick beat Evander for the title.
Evander?
Hey, Martin, you got to bend that left knee a little more. You got the left leg too straight. It's too straight.
Evander's a very nice person as an individual. Very chill. Do you know him well?
I know him, but I'm not going to say I know him well. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, we...
Who do you know well, buddy? Like, can you say Mike Tyson, you know him well?
I've known Mike since he was 16.
That's crazy. Was he always the same?
Yeah. He was really quiet when I met him. I met him at Grossinger's Resort. No, I'm not Grossinger's. Yeah, it was Grossinger's. He was sparring Frank Bruno. It was 1983.
Bruno must have been an adult, no?
Mike was kicking the shit out of him. It was up at Grossinger's. He was up there because it's not too far from where he grew up at it, you know, in the Catskills. And Kevin Rooney used to bring him up. And they would sit there quiet, wouldn't bother nobody. But when the sparring started, and my manager said, "Buddy, we're gonna be looking at one of the greats right here."
I'll never forget.
Eddie Futch was there training Michael Spinks.
He was there too?
Yeah, Eddie Futch was there training Michael Spinks. There was a cruiserweight named Young Joe Lewis there. And then there was a guy named Jeff Sims. God bless, he got killed. He was a heavyweight out of Florida. Who was slow, but strong. He didn't box Mike, but strong as an animal. Strong as a gorilla, man. I mean, he was a kid who was on a chain gang at 15 years old for murder.
Wow.
Then when he got out, he started boxing.
Did Mike knock out Bruno that day?
He was there for 2 weeks. He was beating the shit out of him. He didn't knock him out, but he was beating the shit out of him.
How frustrating is that when you're a professional, an adult, and a kid 16 is whooping you? There's nothing you could do?
Not a damn thing. Okay, Martin, you go ahead, bam, don't pull back. It's like, pop, pop, right there, don't pull back.
But Mike Tyson is one of those few people, like Muhammad Ali, like a Mayweather, like Sugar Ray Leonard, one of them in a generation.
You know, I believe in my heart that what Customato did with Mike, I don't think he can do it with any other fighter.
Why?
It's just that chemistry. That chemistry and the teachings that he did with Mike, I don't think he could have found nobody to execute it as well as Mike did. I mean, Mike executed it to the T. You know, he had Kevin Rooney with him, and he executed that shit to the T, man.
You said he was quiet back then, right?
Yeah.
When did you have a chance to sit down and talk to him like a person? Like, we were talking now, like, just chilling.
When I trained him for like 2 weeks.
You did?
Yeah.
Why only 2 weeks?
Because I told him to go home.
You didn't want to train him?
No. He didn't want to fight anymore.
Oh, okay. But those 2 weeks you had time to spend with him?
Yeah.
And what was that like for you?
It was fun, man, because he called me inside, buddy, I see you at the gym, say, tomorrow at 11. I'm like, all right. I get a call at 5 in the morning. I see you at the gym in an hour.
So you went with them?
Yeah. Excuse me.
Something. That shit would hurt him. There's no time. Yo,